everyone, welcome back to Chester Zoo's live virtual tour. My name's Hayley and I'm one of the rhino keepers here. And with me today I'm going to introduce two of our eastern black rhinos. The one on the left here is Hazina, and the one on the other side is Kitani, and that's her mother. Kitani is 22 years old and her daughter Hazina is 2 years old. And they're just enjoying some browse right now, some willow, out on their paddock. And so black rhinos are well adapted for eating this kind of browse. So there are 5 different types of rhinos. And there are 2 that come from Africa, and this is the smaller species that comes from Africa. So the white rhinos, they're much bigger and have got a wide mouth, and they're adapted to eating grass from the ground. Whereas the black rhinos here, they are much smaller, and they're adapted to pull leaves off of branches, which I'm going to try and demonstrate right now with Italian Marina. So they use their prehensile lip, it's like a hooked lip, to pull the browse in and then strip all the leaves off. And they'll eat some of the smaller branches as well. They've got really big teeth at the back of their mouth that they use to munch. And there's some other features about them which makes them very well adapted to survive in the African environment. So they've got very, very good hearing and a very good sense of smell. And this is used so they can just be able to smell out any predators or smell out any other rhinos that might be around. They do, however, not have very good eyesight. And instead, they rely on these 2 things that right on the front of their faces, their 2 horns. And this is used to defend themselves with. So if a rhino thinks it's in any kind of danger and it can't quite see what's up ahead, it will run at whatever they think is a danger to them, and they'll use their horns. And they'll also use those horns to defend their calves, or maybe the males might be fighting each other to get to a female. So it looks like Kitani and Hazina have had enough of this browse. So we'll just take a step inside to go and see some of our other black rhinos. So these 2 rhinos over here, the one standing up is Melindy, she's 14 years old, and the one sat down is actually having a little suckle from mum at the moment. This is Jemani, and he's 1.5 years old, so he's getting quite big now. So Melindy's come over to have a bit of a munch on her bows. Showing off that lovely lip again. So Jemani over there is our latest calf that we've had. And we've actually been very successful at breeding Eastern Black Rhino, which considering how threatened they are out in the wild, is extremely important. We do this through quite a structured way when we mix some of the males and females together, because using scientific hormone techniques, so we collect the fecal samples, this is tested in our labs on site, we're able to determine when the females are in estrus and when we can most successfully have a rhino pregnancy. And so this is something we're really proud of at Chester Zoo, that we're able to have so many calves through using these techniques. And they are actually using these techniques out in Kenya at the moment to try and help boost their populations in the wild too. And obviously in the wild, rhinos are heavily poached, sadly, for their horn, which is simply made out of strands of keratin, just like you would get in your fingernails. But due to demand from Asian markets, sadly these guys are being picked very heavily, and they rely on our help and funding to give them protection from these poachers. And so the rangers out in the wild are doing an absolutely amazing job trying to protect these guys. And obviously at the moment, with the coronavirus and the state of everything, it's extremely important that we still try and help fund all of this as best we can, to ensure that there are enough rangers to keep protecting all of the wildlife out there. We're going to go and join Katani and Hazina back outside again. In the wild, and the only reason we have these two sets of rhinos together are because they are a mother and a calf, and the calf normally gets to around the age of between 2 and 4 years old, when it will normally start moving away from its mother in the wild. And so we tend to try and recreate that here. We have lots of different paddocks, so we have this one here, and they're all interconnected. So all the black rhinos are completely kept solitary unless it's a mother with its calf. Yeah. And having all of these paddocks open like this means that we can move our rhinos around when we want to breed with them, whether we want maybe they're pregnant and they need to have their calf. Nine black rhinos here. And we're back with Lindsay and Jemani again. Just as you have also been involved in another really exciting venture, in that the eastern black rhinos have been... hello, Melindy. Are you coming to say hi? So yes, we've been trying to help repopulate the wild population of black rhinos by taking some of our European-bred eastern black rhinos and translocating them to Africa. So recently, this beginning of this year, 5 rhinos were sent from European zoos to Rwanda, and they're currently settling in over there. And earlier this year, I was lucky enough to go to Uganda to talk with them about the future prospect of them getting black rhinos, which would be absolutely amazing if that could happen. So I think we're gonna leave it here. Leave you with just looking at Belindy there. Okay, so thank you very much for joining us here, looking at the very wonderful eastern black rhinos. Next, at 12 o'clock, you're going to be heading over to the Tsavo Bird Aviary. Yeah.